Welcome all. That day we have started our new lesson for lesson number 14, that is light. So we have seen some of the concepts from it, the reflection of light, how we can see an object. We can see an object when the reflected rays fall on our eyes. You have seen your image formed in the surface, such as the new steel dish, the glossy granite cladding of the wall, and the water which is there in the lake. So you can also make some similar examples. You can form the list out of it. So now, images in the plane mirror. When you see the mirror, if you stand in front of the mirror, you can see your picture in it. When you are raising your right hand, which hand you can see in the picture is raised? You will see that your left hand is raised. So always remember one thing: the left and the right side of the original object appears to be exchanged in the mirror image. If you are raising your right hand in the image, you can see your left hand has been raised. Or if you are raising your left hand, you can see the right hand is raised. The image is as far behind the mirror as the object is in front of it. How much near or how much far you are from that particular mirror, it will determine the object in front of it. Means what? The image is as far behind in the mirror as object is in front of it. How much close you will stand in front of the mirror, that much far behind you can see your image formed in it. And the size of the image is same as the size of the object. Your nose will not appear to be big, your eyes or your fingers will not appear to be tall or big one. However you are, in which position you are, same you are going to be appeared in the mirror itself. These are the properties of the mirror. So the next part is the pinhole camera. What is actually pinhole camera? I'll just tell you. Pinhole camera is the one in which you can see the inverted image. Here you can see the how the actual processing is. In pinhole camera, there is an inverted image formed in front of it. How they have prepared it, just see. Take an empty cylindrical box, remove its cap on one side and paste a thin white paper on it. Make the small hole at the center of the cap. Just light the candle and hold the box in such a way that the flame of the candle is front of the hole. You will see the upside down image formed on the thin paper of the other end. So this is an inverted image, and because of the pinhole camera you can see the inverted image, the upside down or downward upside movement or picture of that particular object. So the next one is transparent, opaque and translucent. So here they have told you to identify the transparent, opaque and translucent objects. Piece of a glass is a transparent thing, wax paper is translucent, tinted glass is translucent, oil paper is translucent, white plastic is transparent. So what is actually transparent, translucent and opaque? Transparent means what? You can clearly see the another thing. You can clearly see an image which is opposite to you through it. Transparent means what? You can clearly see the image through a particular object. Translucent means what? You will not see the full object, but you will see it partially. And opaque means what? You will see nothing. For example, if you are in a room, you cannot see what is outside. You can see through a window, but not from a wall itself. The materials through which the light passes is said to be as transparent. The material through which the light does not pass is said to be as opaque. And the material through which light passes but partially is said to be as translucent. Okay, now how the formation of shadow or how shadow is formed? When an opaque object is coming in front of the source of a light, the shadow, one of the reflection of it is just falling at the back, and that nothing but is said to be as the shadow of an object. If an opaque object comes in the way of the source light, light does not pass through it. As a result, the light does not reach the wall and that part remains dark, and that dark part is nothing but said to be as shadow. Always remember one thing: the shadow of an object is always casted opposite to the source of the light. So now you can do these things. If you see here, when an object is near to the wall, that time the image or the shadow is little small, but when he is far away, you can see the shadow is too big. Always remember, it is always casted opposite to the source of light. So the shadow of an object is formed only when the light does not pass through it. The kind of the shadow it forms depend upon the relative distance. I have told you how much far or how much near it is to the particular wall, it will determine the distance or it will determine the how much big the shadow is. We can see easily note the changes in the morning, in the afternoon and in the evening also. It only determines because of the sun position. When you are walking on the road, you can see that your shadow has been casted at the back. That time you can tell where the sun position actually is. Okay, the sundial means what? Sundial is an instrument earlier which was used to determine the time, or it was used for determining the clock. It was used for telling because of the formation of the shadow what actually the time is. So it is the largest sundial is at Jantar Mantar in New Delhi. Now we are going to see about C.V. Raman sir. He was the one who have did his great work in the field or in the physics. He is used or his work is used or known as Raman effect, which was regarded or which was related to scattering of light. He discovered this effect on 1928, and which is celebrated as National Science Day since 1987 means till date it has been celebrated. So I hope you have understood this lesson. We will see the next lesson soon. Thank you.